morning, children. So yesterday we were discussing about the major components of the nutrients, that is carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Okay, then we also were going to do the next activity as the testing of the nutrients. Okay, so let us start. First let us test the different food items to see if there is carbohydrate. So we are going to see the test of carbohydrates. Okay, there are many types of carbohydrates. The main carbohydrate found in our food are in the form of starch and sugars, right? They are in the form of starch and sugar. These two are the major source of carbohydrates. Okay, so let us see the test of starch. Okay, let us see the test of starch. Means by doing this test we will come to know whether carbohydrates is present in the food item or not. Okay, let us see. Take a small quantity of food item or a raw ingredient, put 2 or 3 drops of dilute iodine, right? Any raw material you take, raw item, and put 2 or 3 drops of iodine. Okay, observe if there is any change in the color of the food item. Whatever item we are taking, when we put 2 or 3 drops of iodine solution, we have to see whether that food item has changed its color or no. Did it turn blue or black, right? Blue, black, somewhat like that color. Okay, a blue black color indicates that it contains starch, right? Change in color, we have to see. If blue or black, if that food items is converted into blue or black color or blue black color, then that food item which we have taken contains starch, means it contains carbohydrates. Is that clear? Okay, fine. Repeat this test with the other food items to find out whether starch is present or no. Okay, fine. Now we will see the next is the test for protein. Okay, let us see the test for protein. Take a small quantity of a food for testing. If the food you want to test is a solid, you first need to make a paste or powder of it. Grind or mash a small quantity of food item. Put some of these in a clean test tube and add 10 drops of water to it and shake it in the test tube. What you have to do? First, you have to take any item, whatever item you want to test for protein. What you have to do? You have to either smash it or put it in powder form. Should be in a powder form, right? After that, what you have to do, you have to put that thing, the mashed thing or the powdered thing, in the test tube, and then put 10 drops of water in it, right? Then what you have to do, using a dropper, add 2 drops of solution of copper sulfate and 10 drops of caustic soda. So you have to take a food item, right? Take a food item, mash it or make its powder. Then you have to add water and then few drops of copper sulfate. Copper sulfate and caustic soda. Children, these are the names of 2 chemicals. Okay, so just now there is no need for you to go into detail. Just remember the names of these 2 chemicals. Right, you have to add 2 or 3 drops of copper sulfate and caustic soda to that test tube. And then what we have to do? We have to shake it well. Okay. What did you see? Did the contents of the test tube turn violet? A violet color indicates the presence of proteins in the food item. What is the color change? Color change is violet, right? Okay, so if when you put copper sulfate and caustic soda in that test tube and if that color becomes violet, right, then that food item which we have taken contains proteins. Is that clear? Okay, fine. Now, so today what we have done, we have seen the test of starch and the test of proteins. In the test of starch, what you have to do? You have to put iodine solution and see whether the color change is blue-black. And for the test of protein, what you have to do? You have to put a mixture of copper sulfate and caustic soda and see the color change. If it is violet, then the protein is present. And if it doesn't change, then there is no protein present. You have to keep in mind that whenever we are checking or testing the presence of any nutrient, it should be in the powder form. First you just put powder or just mash it, fine. Why you have to do this? Because when you put this solution, it can mix properly together. Is that clear, children? Okay, so in the next period we will continue with the test for fats. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.